was Christmas on the island of Solar. All the engines were working hard. Thomas and Toby were busy carrying people and parcels up and down the branch line. Everyone was happy. Only the coaches, Annie and Clarabelle, were complaining.
It's always the same before Christmas, they groaned. We feel so full. We feel so full.
Oh, come on, said Thomas. Where's your festive spirit? Christmas Day is almost here. By the side of the track was a little cottage with a familiar figure waving to them. It's Mrs. Kindly, whistled Thomas.
Beep, beep.
Happy Christmas. Thomas always felt better for sleep. Christmas just wouldn't be Christmas without Mrs. Kindly, he said to himself. When work was over, Thomas went to sleep. Exactly, said Thomas. So now I think we should all give her a special Christmas party. Everyone was getting very excited.
Says he'll help to rescue her. You must help too, Thomas.
There's no point. Thomas hates snow, but he said greatly, I try, sir. We must rescue her. We must. There's a good engine. You have to get a man to train for me. So Thomas charged.
Sometimes he swept them aside, sometimes they stuck fast. And the men had to loosen them. But at the cutting near the cottage, they could go no further.
Look at that, exclaimed Thomas' fireman.
Beep, beep.
Here we are. An answering wave came from an upstairs window.
Why don't they get it?
Then they heard a familiar sound. That's Terrence, the tractor, said Thomas. He's come to help, too. Sure enough, Terrence had a snowplow and was working hard.
At long last, the rescue was complete.
He took the tired workman home.
Terrence said goodbye to Mrs. Kindly and promised to take care of her cottage as he watched them all set off. The engines made good time. No more snow had fallen, but the yard was dark.
Wish you a Merry Christmas, we wish you
a Merry Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas, and a happy